Watch Entertainment Circle every Saturday morning at 11 o'clock on Comcast 49 with host Shayla Pav. Meet the artists from country, pop, Latino, and classical, all in one fast-paced entertainment show. Join us on movie sets, in the recording studios with artists, and behind the scenes as they make their music videos. Join us at the Oscars, the ACAs, the CMA award shows, and many more. Entertainment Circle, Saturday, 11 o'clock a.m., Comcast 49. Saturday at 11 o'clock, Comcast 49. Tune in!
DJ Miller will do whatever it takes to salsa. No, I'm just kidding. His single, Whatever It Takes, you can go purchase it on iTunes or on his website, djcountry.com. And now we got a one-on-one with Sierra Hall, the talented mandolin player. Watch. Sierra is remarkably talented, beautiful human being. Success could not come to a more worthy person. I adore her. Alison Krauss said that. And she's here with me. I'm talking about Sierra Hall. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. It's so great to meet you.
Oh, thank you. Nice to meet you.
Thank you. You are only 19. And you already have your second album out. What inspires you?
Oh, well, I mean, I just love music, you know, and I guess you can find inspiration everywhere, but I've loved playing music since I've been about 8 years old, and when I got started, grew up singing, and just, you know, I just love it. It's great.
I was gonna ask you that. When did you know that you have passion for mandolin and singing, and when do you know that that was your thing?
Well, I grew up singing in church, you know, and I guess when I first started playing mandolin around the age of 8, it was then that I really started realizing I love music, and it's really, you know, quickly hit me that it's what I wanted to do with my life. So I feel like pretty much ever since I started playing, I've always known that that's really what I wanted to do.
That's wonderful. How are you balancing school and going on tour and writing?
Well, it's kind of hard. It's hard. You know, I really have to try to stay focused. And luckily, I've got a bunch of great people who, you know, help me and make things easier. And, you know, the school, Berkeley, is really supportive. And they're great about giving me time when I need to go out and travel and play and stuff. So it's great to have such a good support team. There's no way I could do it without that, you know.
Your professor called you that you are a mandolin prodigy. What do you think about that?
Oh, well. Well, there's a lot of great players out there. It's really nice to for anybody to like what I'm doing, so.
I think you are. So oh, don't be shy about it. Your voice is just like Alison Krauss, and it's very sweet and melodic.
Oh, thanks.
Do you think that you see yourself someday singing a duet with her?
Probably so, just because, you know, Alison's a good friend of mine, and I've definitely been very influenced by her, and, you know, I grew up listening to her, so. You know, I'm sure every now and then I'll go play things with her and her band. So I'm sure maybe at some point we might be able to do something together. That'd certainly be fun and be a neat thing to get to do.
Daybreak is your second album. 7 or 12 tracks you wrote. What inspired you for this album?
A lot of those songs, I guess, I wrote probably a couple years ago. Mm-hmm. And since then, I've, you know, definitely learned a lot through being in college and being at a music school and a lot of different things. But a lot of these tunes I wrote before even going to college. And I think, you know, a lot of the stuff I've said often, you know, about Berkeley is I think it just gave me a new confidence to be able to feel good about doing some of the stuff that I already loved and not feeling like I had to put myself in a box, you know. So
okay, so why do you name it Daybreak?
There's a song on the record called Daybreak, and so I just felt like that would make for a good
be
title.
The really good break. Come on, give me a daybreak. So college, when are you going to finish that?
I'll be actually finished up in May and moving to Nashville, and I did a two-year program there, so I'll be finished up.
So we'll be seeing more of you.
I hope so, yeah.
Great. Future endeavors?
Oh, just to keep playing and traveling and making records. I have a band that I play with, Sierra Hall and Highway 111, and, you know, just hoping to get busier and busier with those guys and to keep trying to get better, you know, just to keep working and moving forward.
Can you get any better?
Oh, gosh. I hope so. You know,
there's always room for improvement, right?
Oh, definitely. I mean, I still feel like I'm just at the beginning of where I really hope to be someday.
Okay. You're fantastic already.
Oh,
so keep
you.
On it.
Okay.
So in this music video, you look like this innocent little girl. You can act. You can sing. You can play mandolin. Any other surprises that we may know of? Any other hidden talents?
Oh, I don't know. Probably that's probably all I got right there.
Really? Okay. You just sound really solid right there. And you say, now you learned to say y'all yet?
Y'all?
Yeah.
That's my language right there.
Okay, good. So any other music video coming up yet?
There's been talk about doing another one, so hopefully we'll be able to do another one off the record if things
get any favorite
going forward. Probably the title cut, I would say, would be the next video.
Okay, so we'll looking
see.
For it.
Don't hold me to it, you never know. But
okay, you have a blast tonight at the party.
Thank you, we will.
And come back and see us.
All right, that sounds good.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
Don't go nowhere, we continue with more on Entertainment Circle.